Palash Nandy, CEO Numeric, based out of Chennai. Well, in a typical medical facility, you have different aspects of the usage of power. So on one side, there is the infrastructure of the building itself, both on the power side as well as the digital infrastructure. Then there is the medical equipments on its own. On the other hand, there is these emergency services, whether in terms of evacuation, etc. And then finally, more and more, there is requirement of data storage in medical facilities. So there is a power need for the data storage applications. And each one of them have their own unique, let's say, issues or problems. But commonly, there are two main problems that exist everywhere. One is the issue of the quality of the power. And second is the issue of the continuity of the power. And both of these affects all these different four applications that I just spoke about. So the UPS, the basic purpose of the UPS in any application is to provide these two things, which are the main issues. One, to provide the right quality of power and consistently provide the right quality of power. And two is to ensure the continuity of power whenever the mains fails. So since most of these equipments are now electronic, they are more susceptible to the differences in the power quality. And plus, especially in the medical facility, continuity of power is an absolute must. It is not a good to have, but it is an absolute must. So which makes UPS an absolute necessity in any medical facility. So I go back to what I said in the beginning, that for us, we have divided the healthcare installation in four different parts. And there cannot be one solution for all those four different parts. So therefore, the need of equipments is specific. So we've got solutions, whether single phase or three phase UPS, meant only for that. Then there is needs of the infrastructure itself, whether electrical or digital. There are specific products for that. And then finally, there are also specific products for data storage applications. Many of the healthcare institutes, they are putting a micro data center within the institute itself. So you need a specific rack-mounted UPS that goes into the micro data centers. So we, instead of offering a solution that one size fits all, we have specific solutions for the four different specific applications within any healthcare facility. So let's take, for example, let me start with the easier one first, the data storage applications. So instead of in many institutes where the institutes are big enough, they have a local data center. And nowadays, with the advent of micro data centers, which is typically a digital rack with servers, with UPS, with PDUs, all inside one, refrigerated, I mean, air conditioned or otherwise. So here you need a UPS, which is a very high density UPS, meaning in a single rack, you can go up to 10 kilovolts, kilovolt ampere actually, we call it 10 kVA. But it has to be in a 2U format. So this is a specific application for these micro data centers within, let's say, a big hospital. On the other hand, when you look at the equipments, so they require both continuity of supply as well as the quality of supply. And within the quality of supply, the voltage plays a major issue. So we have got something as we call as a servo stabilizer, which is specifically for that application, which is able to withstand the variation of the voltage from the, let's say, electric supply, and then be able to pass on to the equipment a voltage which is extremely stable so that the equipment is able to do its job well. So this is again a specific need. On the infrastructure side, which is managing all the lights and the power, there your sensitivity level is not necessarily required of that level of a very high quality. So you have specific products which are, let's say, the emphasis is more about the amount of power available than the very sensitivity of the power. So you have a specific product range for that. In some applications, it is very important that you've got an inbuilt transformer inside the UPS because, again, of the sensitivity nature of the final equipment to which it will supply power. So we've got UPSs with an inbuilt transformer. So what I'm trying to say is that instead of having one solution across all the applications, we've identified the different needs of the different applications and have a solution specifically meant for that. It's absolutely crucial because unclear power means, let's take an example of imaging instruments. So if the power is not clear, then there would be disturbance in the visual of the imaging instruments, which affects diagnosis of patients. So this is just an example, but whichever equipment you take, it requires an absolute clean power. And this is something that is becoming, let's say, more and more relevant because we are having more and more high-tech equipments in all healthcare facilities, irrespective of whether it is in the metros or the non-metros. So again, it's the quality of power and the continuity of power that becomes important. One affects the performance of the product, and the second affects the continuance of the performance of that product. So the market of power in the healthcare has been booming. Just to give you a stat, in terms of the healthcare infrastructure in India, we believe it is growing at the pace of between 10 and 12% year on year. So this also has an impact on the power. Since the healthcare industry is becoming, let's say, more and more modern, so the requirement of power per installation is also increasing. So all in all, the power market should definitely be growing in the region of 15 to 20% year on year as far as the healthcare industry is concerned. So Numeric is today a 34-year-old organization. And till 2012, it was privately owned, family-owned business. And then in 2012, it decided to join the larger Legrand Group, which is a 6 billion euro organization across the world. So since 2012, Numeric is a part of Legrand. And as a consequence of this partnership, we today have what we call our organization as a global organization. We have access to global expertise, but very strong local knowledge. So this combination is unique. Over a period of time, we have been rated as the number one in single-phase UPS for the last 26 years consecutively. So this gives us a lot of strength. The service infrastructure of 254 service centers, 1,200 people, also gives us a lot of strength. But in the meantime, we have moved from being just a single-phase company, which was the case when Numeric started 34 years back. To now as a company that is able to give solutions from very low power requirements, 600 VA, to very, very high power requirements. I'm talking about, let's say, 21 megawatt solutions. So today, we are able to give a complete offer across all verticals, and we have identified healthcare as one of those six verticals that we believe have a strong potential of growth in India, and we are focusing a lot on that. So Numeric, in the past 3-4 years, we've been growing very well. Just to give us statistics, our growth is always 2 times the growth of the market. This is what has been happening in the last 3-4 years. This is something that we want to continue. India is a very, very, impressive market for us. We want to continue to build our presence in India. We already have a big presence, both in terms of product offer as well as the service infrastructure, because UPS needs a lot of service. Just to give a fact, we've got 254 service centers, 1,200 people working in service. So this is something that we want to keep on emphasizing upon and to build upon this. Now we are automizing our service operations to make it much more efficient. So in terms of continuously upgrading a product offer based on the needs of the market, continuing to automate all our processes so that the customer gets a better benefit. This is something that we will continue to do because we are extremely bullish about the market in India.